Hey everybody, in today's electrical troubleshooting video, we're going to focus on the ignition system of the bike. We're going to show you the routing and the logic of the circuit. We're going to test the components of the circuit, as well as the switches and the wire routing. And we're going to put it all together and show you how the whole thing works once reassembled on the bike. So when we're dealing with the ignition system on a lot of these vintage motorcycles, these old Hondas, one of the things you're going to find different between them is the number of contact points and ignition coils that might exist on the motorcycle. And that has to do with engine architecture and ignition system architecture per bike. So you're going to always have at least one set of points, if not two. And there are also some bikes, depending on their architecture, have three sets of points. It just depends on the bike's design, the engine's design. We're going to trace the circuit, show you the path the electrons are traveling. Always, we start with ground, and we all know that the metal engine case and the frame is on the negative side of the battery, which is ground. If you have not watched our video on ground circuit, make sure you check that out first so you understand the logic of how ground works. So we are starting off with ground, and the ignition points, which are basically just switches, are mounted to a plate, which is all hooked to the engine case here. So again, this is all ground. With the points, as I said, they are a switch and they are left and right specific. We have a parallel circuit. A left side point goes into the yellow wire here and goes into our left coil. The right side point does the same thing on the right side. It goes into this blue wire, splits up, goes to the right side coil. And then they merge together. They merge together into a single wire that is black with a white stripe on it. This is where we go from two parallel circuits to a singular circuit. That black and white wire takes us up to our handlebar switch with a kill switch. Now, most bikes have a kill switch. There are a few models of the Hondas which don't have kill switches. They're usually on the earlier bikes built in the mid to late 60s. Heads up, if your bike does not have a big red kill switch here, most do. Kill switch operates in three positions. Middle position is on or run. Whether it's rocked up or down is gonna be off. So it's a three position switch with only one position that actually connects. From the kill switch, we are going to be tapped into our 12 volt positive side of the circuit. We have a video on understanding 12 volt positive side of the circuit, so make sure you watch that video before you dive into it. In this case, it's going to be a solid black wire. And as we've learned in that other video, that solid black wire ties into all the other solid black 12 volt positives that are in the system here, which all stem from the key switch. Our key switch is our master disconnect from everything. From our key switch, it goes from being the solid black wire to a red wire, all the way back to the positive side of the battery, which is always our finish line for every circuit here on the bike. The approach on testing this particular circuit for the ignition system is going to be a little different than some of the other videos. We're kind of doing it from either side, and we're going to meet in the middle as far as the different components, because there are so many pieces that are in parallel and then series to each other on the circuit. So the first thing I'm going to test is actually going to be our ignition points. Actually, the first thing I'm going to test is to make sure I have good battery power and my test light's working. So connect to ground and over the positive side of the battery, and is my test light on? My test light's good. Always test your test light and make sure your battery is working. As we mentioned previously, we have a left and right side point. It is important to understand that the left side ignition point here, literally the left one, connects to the left side ignition coil. We have a yellow wire here that represents that point up through here, and it connects up here to the wire for this left side coil, and the left side coil is the one that triggers the left side spark plug for the left side cylinder. So it's always left, left, left. Same goes to the right side. Right point, right side ignition coil on the bike, right side spark plug. If you have them unplugged or reversed, you'll never get the bike started, because it's easy to unplug these and mix up the connections. So I'm gonna go ahead and unplug both ignition points here, both the left and right side, from the circuit. So now they are isolated. And we're gonna see if these are working right now. And I might have to rotate the engine a couple times, because, for example, this left side point is a little bit open, as it should be when you spin the engine over, but our right side looks to be closed. So I'm gonna check that right side one first. And here's how I'm gonna do it. We know that this is cooked to ground already. I'm gonna connect my test light here to my right side wire, like that. And then I'm just gonna take the test light over here to the battery. I'm gonna touch it into the positive side of the battery. See it light up? Now let's see what happens if I actually open the point. Test light should go off. All right. On, off, on, off, on, off. All right, that's good. That says that point is actually making electrical contact for the right side. We'll do the same test on the left side here in a second. I went ahead and rotated the engine revolution, so now it looks like the points are actually touching, which means that they're making contact here. Here's our left side, so I'm gonna hook that yellow wire to our test light here. Yellow, it's a little hard to see with years of oil and grime on it, but that's what it is. And then our test light to our positive side of our battery. Test light's on, that means we're making contact. And if I open the point, the test light should go off. Sure enough, it does. So that says that the circuit is working as far as continuity to the circuit. We're gonna leave these be, and we're gonna go around the other side of the bike, and we're gonna test the power from the coils to the positive side of the battery. We are now on the right side of the bike and amongst this cluster of wires here. We have this is our right side ignition coil that goes to the right spark plug here. Right. And out of the harness here, we have this black wire with a white stripe on it. And it goes into a double connector here, where both we have black wire with white stripes. Each of these wires goes to each of these coils. It doesn't matter which one's plugged into what on this side, because this is our 12-volt positive side. I'm gonna unplug these two right here. Those go to our coil, for example. We can see how this one here goes to this coil. Again, it doesn't matter on the 12-volt positive side. It only matters on the negative side of the coil going to the points. Now we're gonna check for power from here all the way to the positive side of the battery. I'm gonna take my test light, I'm gonna connect to ground. Test light into the terminal here, just to have it, and just making sure that pedal piece doesn't touch anything else. I'm gonna go turn on my key switch. Key switch is on, and then I'm gonna go up here to my kill switch. Currently the kill switch is set to an off position. I should set it to the on position. The test light should kick on. Test light's on. Let me go to the other position there. Off, on, off. So what this tells me is that from this part of the wiring harness that has 12 volt positive power coming from the coils, from here through the kill switch, through the key switch, all the way back to the positive side of the battery, our circuit is good. We're back on the left side of the bike. What I've done is I've plugged both the right side and left side ignition coil back into the harness. That means the black and white wires off of each coil are plugged back into the connector for the black and white to the harness. And what we're gonna check is, are we getting power through the coils? I'm gonna connect my test light to ground. Turn on my key. Turn on my kill switch. There, and I'm gonna come in right on that connector there. Test light kicks on, that means I have power through that coil. Let's test this side. Power through that side, that's good. Now let's say you had power on that 12 volt positive side, the black white wire coming out of the harness, but you didn't have power coming through the coil here on the test light. That would mean that the coil is bad. For whatever reason, there's not continuity through the coil, or something internally is disconnected with it, and you're not getting power, because we should have power through the coil like that. While we're here, you're probably looking at these red wires to go up to our condenser. Our condenser is right there on this bike. We're not gonna test the condenser in this video. We do have a condenser test on our ignition troubleshooting video, so make sure you check that out because you have to test the condenser in context of the bike running right now. But now we have power through the coils. That's good. We're gonna do two more tests here, and they're gonna be specific to the left side and right side of the bike. So basically four tests, just two tests repeated over and over again. And so far, this is what we've checked. We've checked that the ignition points are making good contact through their circuit. We've verified that we have 12 volt positive power through the coils and through the rest of our circuit, through our kill switch back to the positive side of the battery. So what's disconnected currently is the ignition coils from the points, but we're gonna test the coils to see if they're properly triggering the spark plug without the points. We're gonna manually trigger the coil, and then we're gonna hook the points up to it and trigger it with the points and the kickstarter to see if it works. In order to do this, I have my spark plug out, I have my spark plug in my spark plug boot, and I'm gonna be touching my spark plug to ground, which we know is just the engine block. So I'll put that there for now. I'm gonna take my alligator clip jumper, I'm gonna go to the positive side of the wire here on the ignition coil. And what I'm gonna be doing is actually grounding this wire here, charging the coil up as the points would. And anytime I disconnect the wire from ground, spark's gonna happen at the coil, or it should happen at the coil. So power's off here. I'll go ahead and put a key switch on, kill switch on, and let's see what happens. So we're getting spark at the spark plug. There we go, that one's better. It's cleaner right there. All right, I'm gonna plug the ignition points back in to the left side point, to the left side coil here. So that's my yellow wire. And I am going to turn the power on, hit the kickstarter, and see if we get spark right there at the spark plug. All right, key switch on, kill switch to on. Let's hit the kickstarter. Just like the left side, we have to check the right side because they are parallel but independent circuits. So I have the spark plug out for this side. I have power running through the right side coil. I touch my spark plug body to ground. And I have my alligator clip for the wire hooked to the blue wire coming out of this coil. And I'm gonna just strike it against ground, and we're gonna see it spark. Every time I break the connection, it'll spark. So, coil, it's good, making a nice purple spark there. I've plugged in the right side ignition point to the right side coil. Now we're gonna see the whole system in action, so we should be having full contact from ground all the way through the positive side of the battery, and we should be getting spark here. As I move the kickstarter, I put the kill switch to the on position, it is on, and let's give it a kick with the kickstarter. Get it? This concludes the troubleshooting of the ignition system using this Honda CB350. We were able to test all the components individually and then the whole circuit together. In this case, we did get spark at both spark plugs. Now, there's a really important thing I must point out. Just because your ignition system is generating spark does not mean that spark is happening at the correct time in the engine cycle. This is when we talk about ignition timing. You should check out our ignition timing video to go into more detail about that, depending on what kind of bike you have, if it's a twin or a four cylinder. But timing is very important, not just sparks. You can't assume because you have a spark, the engine is gonna run properly. It just verifies, yes, spark is there or not, but timing is also hypercritical on all of these bikes. So make sure you check that out. This is Brendan with Common Motor. It's common-motor.com on the internet. Thank you for watching. Make sure you follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Subscribe to our newsletter via our website, and of course, subscribe to the YouTube channel down below. Make sure you ring the bell for future notifications, and we will see you next time.